The next graphical tool is histogram. Histogram graphically represents the distribution of numerical data. The values are assigned bins and frequency of each bin is plotted. Let's understand that with a simple example of students' height. So you go to a school and you measure the height of all the students there and you note it down. So let's say you have put that 150, 155, 160, again 155, again 150, 151, and so on. So once you have all this information, you want to plot a histogram of that. The first thing which you want to do is create bins. So bins are sort of a buckets in which you need to put each of these numbers. So where does 150 go? In which bin 150 go? In which bin 155 will go? Let's see that. So to create bin, what you do is you look at the lowest number. Let's say 150 was the lowest number here and 170 was the highest number. A student had a height of 170. So now you look at this and you find out that the difference between the lowest and the highest is 20. And now you need to create bins. So how do you create bins? So for that, you need to decide how many numbers of bin you want to have. Let's assume that here we have 100 students. These heights are for 100 students. So a general rule of thumb is square root of n. There are number of other ways also to find out number of bins, but the quite commonly used method is take the square root of the total number of items there. So if these were 100 items and I take square root of 100 and that becomes 10. So I need to create 10 bins here and 20 is the total range here. So 20 divided by 10 gives me 2. So this tells me how to create bin. So each bin has to have a size of 2. So my first bin will be 150 to 152. My second bin is 152 to 154. My third bin is 154 to 156 and so on. And till I go to my last one, which will be 168 to 170. Now, if you see 152 is here and here in both, 152 will go in the first bin and 152.1 will go in the second bin. 152.1. Basically, this is 152.1 to 154. Now, if you start putting all these items, 100 items into these bins, and height is represented by the frequency. So 150 goes here. So I put 150 as a one line. 155 will go in this bin. I put a one line here. 155, this one goes here. I put another line. So this in fact will make a histogram, something which will be looking like this. And let's make it the last one here. So this will be 150 to 152. This one is 152 to 154. And this is the frequency. So you see there are more number of students with this height. There are few students with 150 to 152 height. And then there are a few students with the height of 168 to 170. So this is how you create a histogram. So earlier we saw how to create a histogram and we took an example of student height and we sort of hypothetically created a histogram. The height of students will be normally distributed, and when I say normally distributed, that means most of the students will be having the average height. There will be few students with the very low height and few students with a very high height. So that will look something like this. So let me draw that. And this is frequency and this is the height of students. When you look at this shape, which has more frequency in the middle and a few items on side and which something looks like a bell shaped. So this will be your normally distributed. But even if it's not bell shaped, you can see that this is, first thing is this is symmetrical. The left and the right are more or less similar. It will not be exactly similar, but this will be more or less similar. So this, you can say this one is symmetric and this one is unimodal. Let's talk about unimodal and bimodal. So if this is unimodal, then what will be bimodal? So if your histogram looks something like this, that will be bimodal, and let me draw that. So bimodal will have two peaks instead of one peak. Your bimodal histogram will be having something like this, where it will have two peaks. This is peak number one and this is peak number two. And as you would have already known, mode means the frequency. If something is occurring more number of times, so that is the mode of a data. So here in this data, there will be two modes here. So if you look at the modes, there will be two modes in this data. And that's the reason this is known as bimodal. When you have data which is bimodal, you might want to check whether this data is a mixture of two different things. This might be coming from two different machines. So if machine A and machine B is producing same thing and you are putting everything in a bin, so there is a good possibility that one part of this is coming from machine A and the second part is coming from the machine B. That's what you might want to have a look at that. After bimodal, you might have histogram which is multimodal, and multimodal means there will be multiple peaks. So this might have a peak here, and this might have another peak here, and this might have another peak here. So this will be your multimodal. So your histogram might look like this as well. Or your histogram might look like skewed to right and skewed left. So the example of that will be, this is skewed right. You have more here, more frequency here, and there is a less on right side. So this will be your skewed to right. So this is right skewed histogram. And just opposite to that would be left skewed, and left skewed would be something like this. So this is your left skewed. So if I put a distribution curve, that might look like something like this. This is your right skewed and this is your left skewed. Another example of histogram might be a gap in two bars. So let's say your histogram might look like something like this. So you have something here and then there's nothing in the middle. Then you have this, then you have this. So this one is zero, this one is zero. This one is known as combed. So as if just someone has did the combing in these two. And this could be because of rounding off, because someone might not be recording some values here, and that might be the reason for such type of histogram, which is a combed histogram. And a histogram which is cut off, let's draw that. So you might have a histogram something like this, which looks like a normal, but then you are expecting some values here, some values here, and you don't see any value here because this might have been screened. So someone might have looked at the total production, and this would have been your lower specification limit, upper specification limit. That means the lowest allowed value is this, the highest allowed value is this. So after passing, all the passed pieces are this. So these are your pieces which have passed the inspection. And you, if you look at the lot which was rejected, the histogram for that might look like something like this. So you have some pieces here, and then you don't have anything here in this area, and then you have this. So by looking at this histogram, you can immediately make up mind that these pieces are missing. So someone has already done the screening and removed all these pieces. So what you're getting is pieces which are below the lower limit or above the upper limit. So this could be another shape of histogram based on the type of data which you have. So these were few shapes of histogram which you might come across when you look at the histogram, and based on that you might want to decide about the data, what sort of data you have, whether your data is a unimodal, bimodal, multimodal, or your data is skewed to right or skewed to left, or you have a combed histogram. So after talking about histogram, the shapes of histogram, Now let's look at how do we create a histogram. So we will be using two methods here. One will be using Sigma Excel software, and the second method will be using Microsoft Excel. Let's see how do we create a histogram using these two tools, which are Sigma Excel and Microsoft Excel. So let's start with Sigma Excel first, and then we will go for Microsoft Excel.